Electric eels are one of nature's best. They can make electricity up to 600 volts, way more than the average socket. At a length of more than 2 meters, they are taller than most humans. Despite their name, they are not eels, but they fall in a category of fish called knife fish. Here is a fascinating way how eels manage to generate electricity strong enough to knock down a horse. Electric fishes are mostly found in freshwater rivers of Africa and South America, including the Amazon rainforest. They are divided into two categories, strong electric fish and weak electric fish. Strong electric fish can produce very high voltages, whereas weak electric fish's currents are too weak to stun its prey, so they use it for navigation or communication. Eels have three main organs to help them. The electric organ and hunter's organ are used for high voltage electricity used for stunning the prey. They have thousands of cells called electrocytes in the electric organ, which are stacked up together. Each electrocyte can make up to 0.15 volts. But that doesn't unleash its true power of making up to 600 volts. Electric eels manipulate Pikachu stunts by controlling the flow of ions. Ions are charged atoms. When an atom loses or gains electrons, it gathers either a positive charge or a negative charge. An electron has a negative charge, so losing it will result in an overall positive charge for the atom. That's the main power eels use. In the electrocytes, sodium and potassium ions, which are positively charged, are pumped out of the cell constantly. So there is a positive charge outside and a negative charge inside. But when the eel uses its ability, or fires, using a neurotransmitter called acetylcholine and pacemaker neurons, the charge is reversed. It doesn't pump all the charges outside and allows ions to flow back in. So one side has positive charge inside, while the other has a negative charge on the other side. Thousands of such cells stacked up together have the same pattern. As electricity moves from positive to negative terminals, this makes the eel produce huge shocks, acting like a battery. This is known as an electric organ discharge. There are two types of EODs, pulse type and wave type. Pulse type fish send electric fields at irregular intervals, whereas some weakly electric fishes send continuous wave-like electricity. But why doesn't the fish itself get electrocuted? There are various understandings on this question. They may have special proteins to protect them, or they may twirl their bodies in such shape that prevents electricity from reaching their heart. But the truth is, we still haven't figured that out completely. Eels send out high voltage pulses which twitches the prey's muscles involuntarily. Then the eel attacks again and stuns the prey. Then dinner time. One scientist, Kenneth Catania, has researched on electric eels hunting their prey, and he has found some amazing results in his research. In one of his experiments, he infected the fish with curare, a poison that blocks the junctions connecting nerves and muscles. And when he brought the eel near it, he found that no change happened to the fish. It didn't die, nor its muscles paralyzed. That means the eel directly attacks the nervous system instead of muscles. This was an amazing outcome. It does not attack on the muscles, but directly blocks the nervous system connecting the muscles. Electrolocation is also a fascinating aspect of strong and weakly electric fish. The Sachs organ is used for this purpose. The elephant nose, for example, uses electric organ discharges to locate objects. First, it sends out these signals using the electric organ. If an object is in contact or there is a slight change in the field, the fish uses sensors called electroreceptors buried in the skin and detect the object. This process is called active electrolocation because the source of electricity is their own electric organ. Some fishes cannot generate electricity but can sense it. These animals use passive electrolocation. Sharks can sense their prey by sensing the electric fields sent by them. Amazing! Platypuses, sharks, catfishes, etc. are some animals which cannot make but sense electricity. Electric rays and electric catfishes can also make electricity strong enough to kill their prey, just like the electric eel. But eels are the best with the most powerful shocks. There is an amazing mechanism used by wave-type electricity emitting fish. Since these fishes use electrolocation by sending waves, they send the wave of a particular frequency. So sometimes when two fish of the same frequency come close, just like a radio station, their fields get jammed, enabling them to properly locate objects. So one fish increases its frequency of the electric field while the other decreases its frequency to avoid jamming. This is called the jamming avoidance response. Now this may seem a simple mechanism, but it is one of the most complex responses in animals. Also, it's not that simple changing its frequency. There are detailed, complex studies on jamming avoidance responses. This concept is very important for us humans in neuroscience. One useful application of jamming avoidance response is in face recognition technology. Recently, scientists discovered two new species of electric eels in the Amazon basin. One of these species, Electrophorus voltai, is capable of producing up to 860 volts, making it the strongest electric fish. There is so much to know and love in the world of eels and the animal kingdom. Electric eels thus prove that even though we humans have garnered electricity and made miracles with it, nature will still always be ahead of us. We hope you enjoyed the Ask Scientium. We will be back. Never stop learning.